Earl, and hey guys, it is Sunday, happy Sunday, happy Sunday, fun day. This is Food and Flicks. I'm Kelly Choi, you know that already. This is where we talk about a movie. Hopefully you've seen War for the Planet of the Apes, and I'm sharing with you a recipe that I developed. This one is banana cream pie, the obvious connection to apes. They definitely love bananas, I guess, right? Did you guys see the movie, first of all? Where are you joining me from? Let me know if you're out there, say hello. My friend is shooting for me, so he'll be able to read any comments that come up. But first thing, I just wanna go over a couple of shop talk things. First of all, if you know anybody that likes banana cream pie, share this. And you can follow me on Instagram, my Twitter, and my Facebook, ask me questions here. I'll post all that stuff, as well as the recipes once this goes up. What else should I tell you before we start with the recipe? Why don't we talk about the movie really fast? So I saw this on demand. It came out in July of this year, if I'm not mistaken. Let me look at my notes. The director was, here it is back here. The director is Matt Reeves, 93% on Rotten Tomatoes. And you know, before, not that long ago, I used to not really give a whole lot of credence to Rotten Tomatoes, but because it's kind of like just gathering all of the critics' scores in one spot, it's pretty useful. So did you guys see it, as I'm asking you? The budget was $150 million. It grossed more than $488 million, so a huge success for sure. I think this is like the third in the trio. And on a scale of 1 to 10, I would give it an overall, I'll say, 7. I've seen all of the other two before, but the reason why I couldn't give it any higher, despite the fact that, of course, the cinematography and the CGI is amazing, the title of the movie, War for the Planet of the Apes, doesn't apply. I mean, this movie was very much about family and about avenging, say, a murder, and what is revenge, and the guy who plays Caesar, Andy Serkis, who, if you guys know anything about movies like this on an epic scale, Andy Serkis is amazing. But it's a very interestingly shot movie in that there are a lot of close-ups of the apes, because of course being close to somebody makes you really feel like that person is human. I loved that aspect of it, but I didn't feel there was enough action and fighting as the title leads you to believe. But on a whole, of course, it's really cinema, you know, the cinematography is gorgeous. Woody Harrelson is also in it. He plays like the colonel, aka the bad guy. And this is very much in the perspective of the apes, of Caesar, the main character. So it's his quest and his wrestling with what does it mean to be someone who tries to avenge a death in the family. What does it mean to be humanistic, whether you're an ape or not? I hear some buzzing. Is that something? No. Okay. Anyway, I trust you guys are out there. So, like I said, let me know if you liked it, if you're gonna see it. That is obviously a summer movie, so it's still out there on demand, so you can catch it anytime. All right, should I start with the recipe? I was inspired, as I said, by this movie to make a banana cream pie. This one has no added refined sugars. It's all natural, it's paleo friendly, and I believe, yeah, obviously there's no gluten as well. So I'm gonna show you how to make a really easy almond crust. That's how we're gonna start. And again, I have my notes, I'm gonna post the exact recipe so you guys can make it at home. But this almond crust is super easy and versatile that you could use it for any sweet dessert like this, as well as something savory. Okay, should we get started? Yeah. So my almond flour crust, we're gonna start out, where's my cup? With 2.5 cups of the flour itself. And use any almond flour, not meal because it's coarser, but is that a little more? And almond flour will be perfect for you because it's fine enough so that you can really work with it. So a little bit more. I have one ready to go, so not being exact in this one. So 2.
Sean O'Connor says, let's go, we're starving.
You're starving, I know. Okay, 2.5 cups. So 1 more, 1/2 cup. Sean, I wish you were here so that I could have you taste it with me. All right, be a little more exact, guys, when you're making this. You know that when it comes to baking and stuff. The cool thing about this recipe, though, is there's no baking. I forgot to mention that was so easy. It's just a chilling sort of thing. 2.5 cups of almond flour, 1/3 cup of sweetener. I'm using erythritol. I'm a big fan of it because it doesn't raise blood sugar. It's great for my mom, say, who's diabetic. And if you guys are careful about your sugar intake, use that. It's on Amazon. It's everywhere that you buy, you know, more healthful kinds of things. Back to my recipe. A teaspoon of salt. Always got to add salt to sweet things because it helps bring out the sweetness. It really does. I was watching this Netflix documentary on how to taste food. And the reason why that helps is that when salt is present, when you're eating something sweet, it also taps certain taste buds, shall we say, that make you taste sweetness more. So it's actually a real thing. Where's my spoon? Let's do that. Okay, so I added the salt. Now I'm going to add 1/4 cup of coconut oil. You could also use butter or ghee. I just love coconut oil. And because it's refined, you're not going to taste coconut. You're just going to taste awesome banana, which, of course, we put a lot of. So 1/4 cup. I have this in here because I had to melt it this morning. So my apartment's cold. It's cold in New York, guys. So 1/4 cup of extra virgin expeller pressed coconut oil. I think I need to add a teeny weeny bit more. So that's good on the coconut oil. And a large egg. Where's my egg? Crack the egg in here. One more crack. One large egg goes inside my almond flour crust. We're almost done with it. 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla extract. Where's my vanilla extract? Right here. Anything in baked goods, you got to use vanilla extract. 1/2 teaspoon goes right in like that. And then the last thing, that was it. Yeah, so what I'm gonna do is use my hands. This is how you make the best crust the fastest. So just get the freak in there. That's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna try to be not as crazy as I would if I were alone. I would be using both hands. But because I'm trying to be a little bit gentle. So this is all gonna come together, right? The almond flour, your sweetener, my monk fruit that I'm using, the erythritol, the coconut oil binds it, the egg, vanilla extract. This will come together really nicely. Let me bring my pie pan, because I have this grease too, just so it'll be really easy to put together. All right, I think I'm gonna have to use both my hands, so let's do it. So basically what you wanna do is get it together so it forms a ball. It's almost there, right? I can smell the almond flour goodness with the oil. And a lot of times, if you guys have ever made like a pie crust, you can use a food processor too. But this is just so simple and it comes together so quickly and easily that I figure we'll just make it like that. Look at that. Pretty much done. All right. Hands are a disaster. So I'm going to move this over here into my pan. Try to move my mixing bowl to the side. So then all you're gonna do is press this in. And by now, what are you wanna do is, you know, you should make this the day before you actually wanna say eat it or present it. 350 is your oven temp, preheated. So then you just press it. Press it with your hands, and it should fill the sides of the pan really nicely. You're just gonna go up in it, obviously what's gonna happen. And you know, love it, work with it a little so that it looks nice and even. I'm not gonna spend too much time on it because I still wanna make the filling, which is even faster than I would say the crust. But yeah, just get it up in there. Press it up and do it all the way around. And then you can kind of make it pretty with the palm of your hand. And what you wanna do before you bake it, right? So this is, once it's kind of done, you're gonna take a fork. Do I have a fork handy? You know what, I don't. But what you wanna do is take a fork and poke a bunch of holes in the bottom, because when you bake it, it'll start to rise and it'll get little lumps if you don't put the hole. So fork, poke, 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 354 about, I'd say 10 to 12 minutes, start your timer. I had to bake mine for like, I don't know, 15 minutes or so. Let me wash my hands real fast. Anybody out there, any questions?
No.
Not yet. Okay. Today is the New York City Marathon, so I think all of you guys must be running or something, right? It's okay. You can share this video and watch it another time, of course. Okay. So that's the crust. Let's say that it's baked. I have one that's done, so when I bring it out, we can check that out. So 350, 10 to 12 minutes or so. Keep baking until it's golden brown and crispy on the edges. Now we're just gonna make the filling. And it goes into a blender. Let's get my blender ready. What you're gonna add, let's do it here, is a can of full fat coconut milk. That's gonna be the non-dairy part of this, and this also keeps it paleo, of course. Full fat, don't use light because you need the fat to set, because again, we're not gonna bake this, we're just gonna chill it. So a full fat of any really good organic coconut milk will be perfect. And a third a cup of melted coconut oil. Again, back to the coconut oil. I'll pour this in here and roughly stick it in. Drip, drip. Okay, then the next thing is a cup of bananas. Now you definitely wanna use bananas like this, like almost to the point where it looks rotten, because this is how it's gonna get its sweetness. And if they're more green, just like time it so that they get this way. You can stick it in a brown paper bag. And in a day or so, they get really ripe like this. I mean, trust me when I say that this is perfect for what you want. So you're gonna add a cup of mashed banana. And a cup is roughly 2 medium-sized ones, so we are good to go on that. So I'm just gonna break it. Don't love these hairs in there. I'm gonna break 2 bananas, and these, I mean, don't even need to mash it, they're so soft. One, the second one, perfectly overripe, aka rotten, but of course that's how we want it, because the sweetening power and magic of this, it's just gonna be amaze. Whoa. Okay, 1.5. This last bit goes in, throw this away. 2 cups, roughly 2. Okay, then we're gonna add, I'm gonna wash my hands again. We're gonna add 2 dates. Dates, again, it's the natural sweetness. You could also use figs if you wanted to. Got these dates, love dates. They're so perfect in like desserts if you don't wanna ever use any refined sweeteners. So 2 of these pitted. Just gonna stick it in our blender, take the seeds out, because nobody wants seeds in the banana cream pie. 2 dates. Then we're just gonna add a few spices to it. Super easy. 1/4 a teaspoon of cinnamon goes in. And an 1/8 a teaspoon of clove, another sort of different flavor. It's got a slightly like a spiciness to it too. It's got a kick to it, which I really like. You won't taste it, of course, in this. 1/8 a teaspoon of stevia, just to sweeten it up a little bit more. I like this one. It's just like a regular Whole Foods brand. But it doesn't have an aftertaste. Some people, if you don't want an aftertaste, you know, you can omit it and just use perhaps a little bit more of any other sweetener that you prefer, maybe like a tablespoon of maple syrup. And then 1/4 a teaspoon of vanilla extract. Always putting vanilla extract into baked goods.
Melanie Leitao says hi.
Hi, Melanie. Thank you so much for joining me. And did I say salt? Let's see. I added my coconut milk, the oil, the bananas, the dates, cinnamon clove, salt. Gotta get the salt. A little bit of stevia, vanilla extract. And the last thing is the salt. A good pinch. I'll say roughly 1/8 a teaspoon. Again, salt is a must for desserts. That's it. Then we blend it. Blend and go. Yo. Okay, ready? Bear with me, a little bit of noise to come. So just blend. We'll say that that's totally blended, and what you're gonna do, of course, is this is baked. Consider that it's baked. It's that almond crust. So you did this the day or the night before. This is the filling. And before you pour it, taste it. I always love, where's my spoon? Love to taste it because you can pretty much figure out how it's gonna taste. And the one that I made that I'll show you, I can't wait to try it because, you know, then you'll know for sure like how yummy it is. Oh yeah, that's so good. Mmm, so good. Okay, so then you pour it into, again, this is already baked, right? So, and you blended it perfectly. And all you gotta do now is stick this into your freezer overnight. That's it. And then you come out with, God, I could just like take a spoon and just eat this like a soup. And you come up with this.
This is the one that I did
yesterday. It's gonna look like that. You can tell that the almond flour crust is, of course, perfect and golden brown. And then I made some fresh whipped cream.
Jamie Costa says good morning.
Hi, Jamie. So now we're just gonna dress it and garnish it. What you wanna do, of course, is to make it look pretty. So with whatever you want, chocolate sauce, pistachios that have been roasted, maybe you want some coconut shavings or dark chocolate shavings. I have some chocolate sauce that I'll add. But definitely you wanna garnish with bananas. So let's put some more bananas.
Sean says, looking beautiful as always. Love bananas and banana cream cake. Sounds yummy in my tummy.
Oh, love you, Sean. Thank you so much. I wish I could share it with you in person. Where's my knife? Everything seems to like disappear from me when I'm here. Lose all my marbles. Okay, so we're gonna dress this. We're gonna garnish it. We're gonna make it look really good. So, yeah, what else, guys? Did you all out there who said hello, did you see War for the Planet of the Apes? Did you like it? What would you,
Sentimiento Rosa says, good morning from Rosa in Davenport, Florida.
Hi, Florida! Thank you so much. Is it hot there? What's the weather like right now? Because in New York, it's kind of drizzly today. So we're going to dress this, right? I'm going to just chop some nice banana slices. Definitely have some fresh whipped cream if you're into that. All you have to do, I recently taught a friend how to do this, just buy some heavy whipping cream at the store and then beat it with a beater. That's all it is. Add a little bit of sweetener if you want, like a tiny bit of sugar or honey. All right, so.
Jamie says you like that movie, Cool.
Yeah. And okay, cool.
And Samantha says it's gonna be high of 83 today.
High of 83, that sounds good. Wish I was, having that myself. All right, so I'm just dressing this baby. And I won't spend too much time on it, but if time weren't an issue, I would probably put tons of bananas on it. Maybe add some pistachios. I like the crunch. Think about the texture differences that you want to add to it. So let's keep it simple. And let's do that just for now. Let's add a little one in the middle, right? Got a little mini bop. Not bad. All right, let me wash my hands. We're gonna take a slice. Add some fresh whipped cream. And let me grab a sniffly. Okay, remove my notes. And again, I will post this. If you guys have a recommendation for me for my next food and flicks, let me know if there's a movie that you want to talk about or that you want to see. And then whoever gives me an awesome answer, I will send you a free copy of my book, my tea book, The 7-Day Flat Belly Tea Cleanse. It's on Amazon, but if you can send me that and excite me with another potential food and flicks, I would be happy to send you a book. All right, enough of this. Shall we slice? Yeah. So here is my banana cream pie. There's no dairy. It's paleo friendly, there's no added sweetener, sugar, that's unnatural. And, okay, I'm excited. Is it really the time? Sure, why not? Ooh, it's been sitting out, so it's perfectly, I don't have a proper pie slicer, so. Guys, I don't know if I'm gonna be able to get this out.
Spatula.
Of this, oh, okay. I have a spatula. I took it out and it's gotten slightly wonderfully creamy, so all right. Let's see if I can get my spatula.
We use that red thing. Yep.
Yeah. Well, don't they say, and I probably agree, that sometimes ugly foods are the tastiest?
It's not ugly.
It's not right now, but I don't know if I'm going to get be able to get a nice, beautiful slice. Are you going to be able to taste a slice, Elliot? Okay. Look, it's not totally cooperating, guys. Oh, boy. Maybe the key is just to eat the thing out of the thing. Okay, that looks like total arse, but hey. Oh my god, that's not even like pie form at all. But you know what?
Pudding.
What I would do is take it out like 20 minutes before you're gonna serve it. And then put your whipped cream. Where's my whipped cream? I don't even know if I need a fork because... Oh, this is delicious sludge. I'll tell you. It's gonna be good. So here's my fresh whipped cream that I just made. It looks like more sludge. Sludge on sludge action.
Cynthia Mendes says, looks good enough to eat.
Believe me, I will. This is a dark chocolate sauce. Add a teeny bit of that, too. You know what, though? I gotta tell you, like, I still think it looks tasty. One last wipe. It's called sludge banana cream pie pudding. Okay, here we go. Let's taste it. Yours will look better, but most importantly, it's all about the taste. Get a little bit of that crust in there. Okay, have a great rest of your Sunday. I'm probably going to say goodbye for now because maybe I can talk.
Melanie says, still looks delicious.
Melanie, you're right. It is really good. Super banana-y. Despite the sludgy texture, it's really delicious. And it's kind of awesome when you eat something that's also, you know, that it's healthy too. The crust rocks. Thank you guys for joining me. Have a great rest of your Sunday. And now feed some to you, Elliot, over there. Bye, guys. Hey, everybody. I'm Kelly Choi. And thank you so much for being here. If you're here with me